This film depicts the implementation of two projects undertaken by CMP Tandavanala in the regions of Ikungu Sud and Vatvavi Fituvinani. The HFSI, or Household Food Security Initiatives for Sustainable Development Project, and the PPCMI, or Pro-Poor Carbon Market Initiatives Project. Madagascar possesses one of the most extraordinary concentrations of biodiversity in the world. With 12,000 plant species and 1,000 vertebrates, many of which are endemic to Madagascar, the fourth largest island in the world has proven itself to be a World Heritage Site. So much so that it is widely considered to be one of 34 priority hotspots of biodiversity preservation in the world. As for Fianarantsoa, several zones within the province possess a forest massif, which play a role as a hydro regulator. This provides the region with drinking water and electricity. Sustainable use of natural resources has presently become a dominating social concern at all levels, local, regional, and national. More than 75% of the Malagasy population live in rural areas and depend on nearby natural resources to survive. The urban population regularly exploit the resources as well. Food, wood for energy, and construction supplies are the primary causes. Both the urban and rural populations harvest the resources for various reasons. Consequently, natural resources all over the island are vulnerable to overexploitation.
A new protected area measuring approximately 700,000 acres has just been created. It shelters several species of animals, lemurs included. The lemurs are vital to the area as they are responsible for seed scattering, eating fruit, and dispersing the seeds throughout the protected area. All of the various species found within are responsible for the maintenance of the ecosystem in southern Madagascar. CMP Tandavanala, together with ECO, have chosen to work within the zone situated in the outskirts of the new protected area, particularly within the zones where the risks of human pressure on natural resources are high. The aim is not only to reinforce the protection status of the protected area, but also to respond to the survival needs of the population living in the vicinity of the park.
CMP Tandavanala has chosen a community development approach capable of reaching all social strata. ECO Corporation has valued the important role of civil society by supporting the Tandavanala NGO in its crucial task of promoting a development which is truly effective due to its sustainability. Aiming to help vulnerable strata and protect the environment and the resources within, protects people living now and future generations. CMP's approach is based on the Green Economy Initiative. To ensure continual compliance, the agricultural aid being implemented follows a drawn arrangement and management plan with respect to the purpose of each zone. The projects carried out by Tandavanala, HFSI, and PPCMI benefit from the support of other members of coalition life. To implement the objectives of projects like these, CMP Tandavanala intervenes in four strategic spheres: food security and income improvement, land planning, capacity reinforcement, and climate change.
Component 1, food security and income improvement. Availability and access.
The objective here is to reduce the length of the hungry season and to relieve the pressure exerted on natural resources. The project targets vulnerable families living in distant villages, but who also live near the natural resources. Beforehand, a survey was meticulously carried out to identify the concerned population. However, the target population has increased since then, and now includes members of communities motivated to deal with innovation. With its small available budget, CMP Tandavanala plans to improve the living of 2,100 households in 5 communes, all of which reside within the corridor. As for availability and accessibility, the principle followed is to sensitize regarding the importance of eating nutrient-rich foods which already exist locally. Tandavanala technicians, in collaboration with technical services and local communities, will teach farmers new, high-yielding agricultural techniques. Therefore, we have enacted the following plan. First, we reinforce the supply of optimal agricultural seeds. For example, CMP Tandavanala promoted the use of rice seeds X265 and B22 because rice is the Malagasy staple food and needs to be produced in abundant quantities.
Secondly, we encourage the use of crops with high nutritional value, such as yams and sweet potatoes, with very high calories, beans for protein, tomatoes and zucchini for minerals and needed trace elements. Several households that receive seedlings have already produced high-yielding harvests after just a few months. Most of the harvests are used as a local food source. Some of what is produced was sold, and one portion of the harvest was preserved for the future plantings. There are some people who have already reimbursed the Tandavanala Center the equivalent number of seedlings that have been given to them. Members of the Ambulumandinka community, with help from Tandavanala technicians, did just that with revolving peanut seeds.
I took 15 cans of peanut seeds. I grew them and got 100 cans. I had to sell 50 cans on my parents' death, and the other 15 cans were kept apart for the future seeds and my family foods. These are the left seeds to grow for the next time. I'm very happy to have grown peanuts from Tandavanal. When I harvested the products, I sold the most part of my products. And I have some left for seeds for next year. For the rest, we ate and we sometimes both pound or cook. I've sold as well some peanuts, about 20,000 ariary, and bought this cooking pot.
Since 2012, interventions in 5 communes have allowed CMP Tandavanala to reach and assist 2,917 farmers planting rice, peanuts, vegetables, and beans. One of these farmers is Mr. Mura Huavi, president of the VOE Asachana. He earned money by cultivating and selling vegetables. He then invested his money so that it would generate profit again.
My name is Murawadi, president of Vioyan Chatan. I benefited most from growing vegetables while working with Tandavanal. My wife planted vegetables and we worked together, and then we were able to buy piglet for 35,000 ariary with the money earned. We bred this piglet and sold it for 100,000 ariary. With that money, I began to build this house little by little. As you see, it's not finished yet.
In And finally, education and promotion of long-lasting farming for crops which reinforce food supplies. This, for example, is the case for moringa, a tree very well known for being rich in iron, protein, calcium, vitamin A, vitamin C, and antioxidants.
As it pertains to utilization, CMP Tandavanala worked hard to carry out a campaign about nutrition education on local crops. The campaign targeted women, but interested men were invited to attend as well. CMP Tandavanala has set up 14 special dishes, giving special priority to using local products so as to ease adoption of the program in training. In 2013, the members of Women's Association of Tsaranu were trained in culinary arts. Many of them, such as Mrs. Renku, retained the information given in the training and was able to make the dishes afterwards. Today's special dish is bread made with bananas and peanuts accompanied by taro root balls. These children are reveling in the delight of the new treat. Complementary to this initiative, CMP Tandavanala has recommended the improvement of the farmers' income in order to support all activities which aim at achieving sustainable food security. Here, the main concern is to encourage farmers to plant cash crops with high added values such as coffee and cloves. Why these two products? As it pertains to coffee, the soil is very fertile in these areas and the people living there have had years of experience planting and harvesting coffee. Lack of upkeep, however, has decreased production due to, in large part, the old age of existing plants. Despite this hurdle, reviving better farming practices with coffee can be lucrative for the farmers as it can be locally and internationally marketed.
I'm Clovis, a nursery worker, one who works with the tree saplings. You can see the trees we have now are old and not producing well anymore. The people here are desperate because we can barely harvest any coffee seeds anymore. We consider ourselves lucky if we can get 5 or 10 cans of coffee from Egan trees. This coffee tree is already 50 years old and notice its seeds. At this age, we can only collect 1 can from it. That's the reason why we are planting new ones.
Clove production is purposed for exportation, and since Malagasy products generally have high quality, farmers can earn much higher incomes from foreign currency. It's important to mention that farming these products might take a couple of years to stabilize. Consequently, nature reserve conservation activities will take a couple of years to stabilize as well. In this stage of last year's project, coffee and clove trees planted by the beneficiaries are currently in full expansion, and the farmers will be able to harvest a few years from now.
I planted clove trees for my descendants as an inheritance, so I could provide them with a future. I have just now received about 120 young clove trees from Tandavanala. I hope to harvest the cloves from these trees in 7 years' time. When I do, I expect to receive money from the clove harvest. 1 kilogram of dry cloves is about 20,000 ariary now. But after 7 years, I hope this price will increase. I have desired for a long time to plant coffee trees in Andamavdia, so I can feed and bring up my family. I still don't know what goal my children want to achieve. And for this reason, I need to support my 7 children in their studies. I believe that God may bless me to become richer when the coffee is ready to be harvested.
Among the saplings planted since 2012, we have noticed that more than 300,000 of them are in perfect growth. 42,879 of these are coffee trees, and 11,736 are clove trees. These trees were all initially grown in the Tandavanala ONJ nursery and have been planted on the common reforestation grounds and on the land of local community members. And in all, cover a surface area of 560 hectares spread out in 5 communes of intervention for Tandavanala. Component 2, land planning. Restoration and increasing of wooded areas in order to meet the construction, firewood, and soil amendment needs of area communities. The objective here is to replant trees to be harvested for construction materials on approximately 1,500 acres within 3 years. To do so, CMP Tandavanala is developing a simplified arrangement plan, giving special importance to the different country management areas situated in the vicinity of the forest corridor. These areas include the conservation area, area with right of use, the restoration area, and the production area. On this side of the landscape, the forest massif is classified within the conservation area and the sustainable utilization area. The damaged area is proposed to be a restoration area, and we suggest that the remaining areas be used for farming activities based on the principle of agroecology and green economy. It is inside the restoration and production areas that trees may be planted and farming activities can be undertaken.
This ground is a common planting trees ground for people of Anivran, commune of Ambulmadink, to protect ditches because there is a dam to be protected also. To prevent garbages sprout by the flood into these rice fields, all the young trees planted here were produced from Tandavanala nursery at Ambulmadinka, issued in 2012. As we can see here, these planted trees have reached 10 meters tall.
Our goal is to create a balance between viable ecosystems and socioeconomic development of the population. Component 3, capacity reinforcement. CMP Tandavanala is convinced that the best approach is to make the activities last for a long time. This requires special support for administrative matters from community leaders within the intervention areas. In 2012, CMP Tandavanala assisted the commune of Ankarimbelu to issue national identity cards with the aim of encouraging more environmentally and socially conscious generations to emerge in the future. This component also concentrates on training the local and traditional authorities and the community youth through widespread sensitization programs and cooperation with local mass media. Since 2012, CMP Tandavanala has produced about 100 radio and TV programs on environmental education. A training on inland management was recently provided to traditional and local authorities so as to avoid any land disputes. With support from ECO, CMP Tandavanala and area community members have built two centers for sustainable development in two communes. The centers are used, firstly for capacity building on nutrition and other subjects pertaining to people's lives, government, and environment. Secondly, it will be the main office for community cooperatives that will enact production management and marketing in the future. Mrs. Julie, one of the beneficiaries of the projects undertaken by Tandavanala, acquired knowledge on basket weaving at the Tandavanala Center of Education. This experience helped her to create a new career and improve her and her family's financial situation.
What made me learn at the Nulmadinic Center was to learn about planting. Before, I couldn't make it, but now I can, because of the center of Ambulmadink taught me about speaking mat plating. I mean, we write on it. Some time ago, I bought a mat like this. I paid 5,000 ariar for it. At the time, I was not able to plant. When I made it, I could finish it in 3 days. And I hope to make more. If I can finish 10, I may get much money. When I sell them, my household standard of living can be ameliorated with this money.
In order to reinforce environmental education, CMP Tandavanal has undertaken 13 sensitization campaigns within community constituencies around the protected area, around the Ambusicha Hundruzu Forest Corridor. Every inhabitant was touched by those sensitization sessions, which were focused on a number of topics. For example, the protected areas, the Red Plus, the sustainable management of natural resources, and the benefits obtained from natural resources. Component 4. Climate change. In order to support efforts undertaken in the field of natural resource preservation and to contribute to climate change reduction, the tripart collaboration between ECO, Tandavanala, and Fair Climate Network Southern Africa was created. Together, these groups produced a carbon emission reduction project, which will be registered on the carbon market in accordance to the gold standard methodology. The project promotes energy efficiency technology using high-performance improved cook stoves, which will reduce firewood consumption of rural Malagasy households. This strategy will reduce greenhouse gas emissions, the main source of climate change. After a feasibility assessment of the project, Tandavanala worked with Industrial and Technological National Research Center and local craftsmen to design new prototypes of improved cook stoves that are more adapted to the homes of the corridor residents. The cook stove's name is Sinzuharena, which means the households anticipate future richness by using improved cook stoves. It reduces the time spent in cooking and time collecting firewood. It also improves the quality of indoor air, which directly benefits the health of mothers and children who usually stay inside the kitchen while cooking. Afterwards, the newly designed improved cook stoves were kitchen tested in the field with Fair Climate Network team. Then, 3 laboratory tests of the cook stoves were conducted at the Laboratory of National Industrial and Technological Research Center. The results showed a rate of 54.7% reduction in firewood consumption, and an increase in energy efficiency of 16%. Usually, a family composed of 7 members would burn up to 17 kilograms of dried wood per day for 3 meals when using traditional cooking methods. Whereas with the improved cook stove, the same family will require only 7.5 kilograms of dried wood. This can save 9.5 kilograms of wood per day, saving money and daily expenses as well as trees harvested. One cook stove prototype reduces wood consumption by 2.11 tons per year and reduces greenhouse gas emissions by 2.73 tons of carbon dioxide per year. Following the methodology of the gold standard, the project started with a local stakeholders' consultation on the 20th of August 2014. The workshop gathered all representatives of governmental entities, local ministry departments, technical services, and the beneficiaries, during which the stakeholders were informed about the project and given the opportunity to discuss the impacts it will have on their lives. The purpose is to enhance the project design based on stakeholders' comments and to increase local ownership and/or involvement in the project. In total, 142 participants were present. The discussions and exchanges during the public consultation have shown that the participants were very much interested in the use of improved cook stoves.
The sensitization of the targeted population on the use of improved cook stoves will be easy, in my opinion, due to the problems already being felt in terms of wood supply due to deforestation.
The firewood supply chain is becoming increasingly difficult now. Many people still practice bus fires, tending towards the depletion of forest resources, although we still dispose at the moment wood for energy. The area of supply is becoming increasingly far from the villages, and transporting a bundle of firewood is more and more difficult.
The project has conducted a pilot phase of cookstove production. At the moment, artisans are honing the manufacturing skills of the Sinzuharena cookstove. The cookstoves are made with locally available materials: clay, burned rice bran, brick powder, sheet metal, and iron. The workshop resides in Fianarantsoa. It will ensure the production of 60,000 improved cook stoves during a 10-year period. The technical capacities of clay workers and metal workers will be strengthened by using innovative techniques and machine equipment. Laboratory and kitchen test results, as well as the time spent on the consultations on behalf of the local stakeholders, are part of the project design document, which will be registered for validation. The account has already been opened with Gold Standard Registry for this project. Prospects. After 3 years of implementation, the results have been proven to be very promising. Given the pace at which the partnership is going, it is estimated that within 3 to 5 years, the farmers will produce more than 300 tons of coffee per year and 240 tons of cloves in 7 years with continuous maintenance. Moreover, we will be able to strengthen the protection of natural reserves. This will produce a valuable and durable commodity for Madagascar. As for the PPCMI project, we foresee success in the carbon market in that it will benefit Forest Corridor residents, the overall environment in Madagascar, as well as the global environment. Many ideas have been brought forth after the implementation of the projects. The people directly affected by the projects with Tandavanala are already aiming to capitalize on achievements and experiences gained from the projects. First, there is a need to direct the farmers toward the market while including the green certification process. Second, setting up business plans that are in agreement with the green economy approach. Third, local cooperatives require promotion and partnerships with exportation specialists. Fourth, the field of activities should be extended to other communes not yet touched by the project. Fifth, activities based on land planning and the carbon market must be further developed. After we achieve the first phase of the project, a phase that in some areas has already been achieved, we will need to be ready to implement a second phase of the project in order to maintain and strengthen previous achievements, as well as continue the development process. This development process will continue to use a method of sustainable and responsible development, and will move food-secure communities toward having a real market economy that respects green initiatives.
Maniara de un cuisinichiche anda una mana y araca vaya ruta tu lianana anda una mana y araca vaya ruta tu lianana
una.
We'll be right back.